and push the audio button. And then on your volume, you can turn it down.
Okay, is that here?
Yep. And it's just above the silver.
What?
Just above the silver. There you go. Yep, perfect. Oh. See how it swipes? Start from one side and then swipe over to the left.
Oh, here.
Yep.
Okay. Okay, that's one thing we didn't know.
You gotta have it on a little bit.
Okay, then it got on because I was cleaning this off.
Yep.
That's the way you turn the radio on.
Yep, that's going to open up your audio, and that's going to be your AM, FM, and XM radio. Okay? If you want to switch it, let's say, because it's only on the XM preview, let's push that radio button on the bottom of the screen, and that'll switch to, that'll switch to the AM.
Oh, that's AM, huh?
Yep.
Okay, AM.
And do you like 8:30 AM?
Fine.
I mean, but how do you change it?
You can push radio again to go to FM if you like FM.
No, okay. I mean, how do you change station?
Okay, see where it says seek? The two arrows? You can push those, and that's how you're going to go over. Now, if you directly click on seek right on the word, it'll switch to tune. Okay? Now it'll individually go.
Oh, okay.
So
if we switch to, okay.
Yep, now it'll only switch by one.
One, keep going up. Oh. See, this way. Yeah.
And if you push tune again, it'll go back to seek, so it'll pick up whatever has the best service.
Okay.
Now, if you click and kind of pause on the seek and then scroll up. So click and hold the seek and then scroll it up. Oh. Try to go a little faster and scroll that seek up.
I don't know what you mean, scroll up.
Oh. Swipe it up. There you go. There's your favorites. Okay.
Oh.
Okay.
So what's your favorite radio station?
We don't have one.
Well, if you'd like radio on your steering wheel, you'll see the voice. See that person with the voice in the upper left corner?
Upper left corner. Person with the voice.
Yeah.
Where? Top left. Yep.
This one?
Yep.
Okay.
Now, go ahead and push it. I'm going to show you how you can tune a radio station. Go ahead and push it again.
Okay. Oh, I didn't push
and then wait for the
command,
beep.
Please.
Tune 92.5 FM.
92.5 FM.
Now that's an easier way to do it instead of pushing that arrow every time.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Here, and you.
We have to know the stations.
We
don't know them. But.
Okay.
I used to like 102.9, I think, but they changed that one.
Okay.
Okay. Well, that's handy.
So that's your audio. You got any more questions on audio?
Doesn't this support the radio?
That's your volume, yep. The one he was just pointing at was the volume.
Here.
Yep, and the arrows to the left of the volume. See the arrow that goes up?
Yep.
And just to the left of that. The buttons, there
this
you go.
One?
That's the up button and then the down. That'll go through your favorite radio stations. So that bar that you just swiped up, those are your favorites.
Oh, okay.
So if 92.5 is your favorite, you see where it says 101.3?
Yep.
Click and hold it until it beeps at you. Now that's how you make one of your favorites.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh.
And then.
Gosh. If I...
Okay, now we couldn't figure out how to turn it off.
All right, if you want to turn it off, you see that power button on the left? If you just push it once, okay? If you push it once, it mutes it. And it's just above the silver, remember that. The silver just shows you the outline.
Okay.
Yep. So now if you, and if you click and hold it.
Right here.
There you go. That's how you shut it off.
Oh. Okay.
And remember, it's just above the silver. See that?
Okay.
Wow.
So instead of pushing this thing, I just push there?
There you go, yep.
Okay.
You don't touch the silver anyways?
Nope, you go right above them.
Oh.
Okay, so now we go back.
Or you can push
don't touch the silver.
There you go.
Yeah.
And it's muted right now. See the red button in the upper left? See that?
Yep.
It shows that it's muted, so push the power button just once. Just tap it. Yep, there you go.
What's muted?
Mute just turns the radio off, but still have your screen on. So if you're on the phone or somebody's talking, you can mute it.
Oh, how do you do that?
Just by pushing the power button once. There you go.
And
then click and hold it to turn it off.
I would just, on the way out here, ask her
what's
that.
So it's still on then now. It's muted.
Yep, exactly.
Oh, the radio is still on, though.
No, no, the radio mutes.
Mute.
Turns off.
Oh.
But if I push it and hold it, it goes off.
You're correct. There you go.
Okay, now phone. We don't have a phone in here.
Okay, so we can go ahead and disregard that whole
right.
button there.
Right.
Okay, and OnStar Nav, once we get your OnStar going, when you push that blue button up there, you can tell them where to go and they'll take you there. Okay?
You just give them an address.
Yep, you just give them an address and they take care of it all for you. You don't have to push no buttons or nothing.
Okay.
Okay?
This here you
that
mean?
One, yep. Yeah, that's the OnStar.
The only other one that you really need to pay attention to is probably your climate.
Yeah, not settings.
Settings, you can go into settings and I can go over that with you. So time and date, if you ever need to change the time and date, it should stay up to date with you because it does have the date. So your daylight savings times and all that should be all good. Language, you're going to keep it on English.
Yep.
Valet mode is where you actually can lock that secret compartment. Remember that secret compartment down there?
Yeah.
Yep. That's how you can lock the secret compartment and nobody can go through your radio information as well.
Yeah. You code in to get...
Correct, yep.
We haven't opened that one. Which one? Where was that one?
This
one?
Just above the CD player. See the V just above it? A little bit higher.
Here.
There you go. Yep. There's a swiping motion again.
Yep. Yeah, and that one you can, which we want.
There you go. Yep. Like you never know. You never know if you want to hide some personal belongings in there while you're going in to eat. You know what I mean?
Well, can anybody just do that to one?
Not if you lock it.
Unless we lock it.
You can lock it by valet. Yeah. Yep.
But how do you don't lock it?
Gives you your own code that you can choose.
And then you just hit enter?
Yep.
And then
they'll ask you to do it one more time to make sure that you wanted to lock it.
Okay.
So use the same code twice, and then you get to change the code anytime you want to.
Is all this stuff in the book?
Sure is. Yeah. Go ahead and push the home screen then. Okay. And then climate.
Okay. Just refresh me again, Pandora.
Here on the settings, there's something I wanted to show you.
Okay, but why don't we go through this? He's recording this.
It's on her in there.
Yep. Oh. Pandora is actually one of the smartphones. It's an application for music. So if you do get a smartphone, make sure you call me because I want to get your phone paired up so you have the good Bluetooth. Okay, it's a lot more safe. And then your Pandora is a good music that I can show you.
Okay, now, that's not likely we do.
But the OnStar had sent, we got something in the mail and it had a telephone number on it and it was the wrong number.
Our number was wrong?
Yeah, it was wrong. There was two numbers were interchanged.
Okay. We'll go through the OnStar call after that.
What's
this vehicle personalization?
That's just letting you know.
Climate,
that's this right here. That's just letting you know about this stuff here. It's just explaining it.
But I mean, the one thing I want to, a lot of these things say there.
Yeah, but can we finish climate while he's recording?
I just wanted to go there. It says select on or off.
That's easy exit. So her memory seat's over there. She can change in the settings if she wants to have that seat kick back so it's easier for her to get out. So when you shut the vehicle off, your seat will actually kick back
to
so
get
it's
out.
Easy for you to get out. Yep.
And then when you go get back in, it goes
back. Yeah, but all these things, quite a few of them got select on or off. Well,
that's in your settings.
Select.
Yep, push the home button. I'll show you. So in your settings, okay, push that arrow down, and you'll see vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
Click on vehicle. Okay. Now, those are going to be your different settings.
Here, the collision.
Yep, click on that.
Collision and detection.
Yep. Now, side blind zone alert. Click on that. That's those outside mirrors. And it looks like it's on.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Okay.
So that's how what they're talking about. You're on and off. You can change the settings if you want.
You can't do it by this or anything.
That's radio.
Nope, that's a different on and off switch. No. This is, yep. That's just your power on and off.
Well, it's going to be a lot here to remember. Wow.
Well, some of this we won't even be using. So I'm not that concerned about. We want climate.
Alrighty, so climate.
And this is the one I usually go with.
Okay, so you've seen that already.
Yep.
And you'll see at the top sync. Sync means that it's going to sync or match your driver's side temperature, which is 76 degrees. So if you push sync, it'll make his at 76 as well.
Okay.
Otherwise, he can adjust it himself. And also, if you don't have the climate open, you can use the red and blue arrows. Yeah. Okay? And blue arrows, driver's side, and then passenger side.
Yep.
And you've been using your heated seats? Well, yep.
Air conditioner mode should always be off.
Then, unless you're in the summer, yep.
Yeah.
Unless you're in the summer. Well, yours was on one time.
Yeah, it's, sometimes it's left on because from our summer when we had it to winter, not everybody jumped in and switched it off.
So in order to get it off or on, you just push
that. There you go.
Yeah.
That's it.
Off or on. Yeah.
And then how do you adjust the air conditioner the same way?
Yep, there's the fan right there, and you can use the arrow up and arrow down right there.
Okay. So you said we can change our temp by using these.
Yeah, go ahead and push
going
it. Yeah.
Into climate. Okay.
Yeah, go ahead and push it. You can see it happen.
Yeah.
We go off. Okay. Yeah.
Or they go down.
Okay, then to get it off sync.
What's the auto mean?
Auto is going to adjust to 77 degrees, just like your furnace at home. So if you push auto, and since your temperature's set at 77 degrees, it's going to adjust to 77 degrees as fast as possible for you.
Oh.
Just
oh.
like your furnace at home, you set it at 76 degrees and it works on its own to get to that temperature.
Okay.
Well, otherwise, what does it do?
It's just going to make it automatic to get to that temperature. It's going to adjust the heat to maybe 85 degrees when it's really cold out to make sure it gets to 77 fast. Once it gets to 77, it's going to turn the fan blade down because it's at that maintained temperature. So it's
going to... the fan isn't always going high.
Correct. It's not going to be going at the same speed. It's going to fluctuate.
If I push auto...
Yeah, go ahead and push it. Just above the silver member,
Okay.
So now the fan's going to kick on because it may be 75 degrees in here. So it's going to kick on a little bit higher to make sure it gets 77 degrees, then it's going to tone off.
So it has nothing to do with these.
Well, it does, yes, because it's going to automatic set up your positioning as well. So if it's cold outside and it senses that it's really cold, it's actually going to make it automatic to kick on your defrosters.
Okay.
And the front.
Okay.
Yep.
So you don't have to do it by hand. It will automatically do it.
Correct. Yep. And the defrost, you'll see the front is on the left, right by auto.
Yeah.
And then the rear, and that also kicks on your outside mirrors.
This?
No, the rear defrost.
Oh, this one.
Yeah, that will kick on your outside mirrors and heat those up.
How do we know it's on?
Click it. There you go.
Oh,
yep. It lights up.
And then the car with the arrow inside.
Turn it off, then we'd...
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yep.
The car that what?
And the car that's right next to that with the arrow inside, next to rear defrost, that's circulation.
Oh.
So if you're going past a stinky farm, you can turn that on so you don't have to smell the outside air coming in. Or if it's really, really, really cold outside and it's already warm in your car, you can recycle the cabin heat. Or if it's really, really hot outside, you can recycle the air conditioning in the cabin. Instead of taking the air from outside and bringing it in, it recycles it.
So auto actually would be a good thing to use.
Auto's nice. Yep.
Okay.
So just leave that on.
Yep. And the only way auto will shut off is if you adjust the settings somehow. If you change the fan speed, if you change the positioning.
Just leave it on. You know.
Okay. But now this is not lit up.
Nope, it's on auto. See where it says auto in the middle?
Oh, so then you don't do anything with those.
Yep, so right now it's probably kicking on the defrosters because it's cold outside to make sure you don't have foggy windows.
Okay.
And if you ever get that foggy window because you like the feet and the face, sometimes your windows will get foggy, use the feet and the defrost, and it still gets your feet and face, but it keeps the windows nice and clear.
Clear, okay. Okay, so in order to get auto off, you would get it off by...
Not on the temperature, by fan speed or positioning. So if you change the fan or if you change the position of where it's coming. Yep, there's the fan there, and it's also right by the AC mode up there. So switch the fan once.
This one, you mean?
Yep, do that one. That's the positioning, okay? So now that's manual, okay? Now that it's highlighted, and only the fan is on auto. So if you turn down the fan, see where the fan is up there? If you turn down the fan.
Here?
Yep.
Yeah.
Now that shuts off auto.
Okay. Oh, that shuts off.
See how the light turned off?
Okay. Okay.
And it's only because you're manually changing the settings instead of keeping it on auto.
Now, how do you get the sync
The sink. All he has to do is fluctuate his temperature. So if he changes his temperature, there you go.
Oh, then, okay.
Oh.
Okay. Yeah, I could see where auto probably, you'd get your temperature, the whatever you think, and then.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is that the extent of it?
Yeah, that's about it, actually. And you know where your heated seats are, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we've had those going.
Good.
And the steering wheel.
Okay, cool.
So, how about some of these things down here? Do we know all these?
So, the upper left one, that's how you can tune a radio station. Or if you get a new phone, that's how we can make phone calls. So, let me know if you ever do get a smartphone.
Yeah.
Okay?
Not likely happen. Okay. These are...
That's your cruise control.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, do you know how that works?
No.
Okay, on the right side, you see the symbol with the circle?
Yep.
When you click that, go ahead and push it in. Okay, now look at your speedometer. See the miles per hour, and then you got the cruise control symbol?
Oh, and then
Yep, that's how you know that it's on and ready to go.
Okay.
Now, if you take that whole lever in the middle and pull it down, see where it says set?
Where?
Right by the cruise control.
Here?
Yep, see how it says set below?
Oh, yeah.
Yep, so pull that lever down. Nope, the lever itself. There you go. That's how you would set the speed.
Hold it while you're
getting Would you get
speed?
To that
while
speed?
While you're at the speed, you just pull that down, and it's going to lock in that speed.
Okay.
Now, if you want to cancel the speed, you can see the cruise control symbol with the X through it.
Yep.
And you just push that to cancel the speed. And if you want to resume the speed, just like set, but pushing it up,
okay.
That would be resume. See how it says resume just above there? R-E-S?
Where?
On the top there.
Oh, here.
There you go. Yep, oh, that's okay. Why you would push it up to resume the speed.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay. And then your heated steering wheel on the bottom right.
Yeah.
That. Now, how do you get this off then?
You just
push the X.
Push that one right there. Yep. You can either cancel the speed or you can push that and that turns off the symbol and turns off cruise control, period.
Okay.
What does the X do again?
This is the steering wheel.
On the other side.
The X cancels the speed.
Oh, just the speed.
Yep, just the speed. Cruise control is still ready and active, but it cancels the speed. So let's say you're on a 65 mile an hour road and you had cruise control on, but you're going down in the cities and the speed limit is 45, you would cancel the speed. And if you'd like, if it's a county road, you could reset the cruise control at a different speed.
Okay.
You get what I'm saying?
Yep. And this one, that's phone.
Yep, that hangs up.
Okay.
That shuts off the...
That's the...
And if you push that, it also mutes the radio, too.
Okay. Oh, this one?
Yep.
Oh, okay. Okay.
So if you push it, go ahead and push it. Turn on the radio again. If you push it again, it'll mute.
Wait, push it again?
Yep. And that's how you mute it.
Okay.
And it's still on, though, now. You just muted.
You're just muting it, correct. Yep. It doesn't pause the radio. The radio is always going.
Okay.
Oh, always going?
Always.
Okay. Oh.
And actually, on the HD channels, you can pause live radio, which is kind of crazy.
Okay, now you told us about these.
Okay, and that's the important ones, because you remember your mini display up there, okay? See how it says service theft system? Now, on the service, where it says dismiss, see that? See how it's highlighted and says dismiss?
Yep.
If you push that in, the select button, push it in, there you go. That gets rid of it.
Because
it dismissed it. Okay. So now, right now it's in the digital dash. See how it's got your digital speedometer?
Yes.
See how that's the bigger area?
Yeah.
Now arrow over to the left. Now that's the bigger screen. So that's your compass, and you can scroll up and go through different settings.
By going pushing up?
Nope. There you go. Perfect. There's your timer. And if you keep pushing up, it goes through all your settings.
Okay.
How do you cancel it at any time?
Okay, so there's the trip. It's got 13,000. You want to reset it? So click and hold it in.
Okay.
And
here, you mean.
Click and push it in and hold it. There you go. That's how you reset your tripometers, your average fuel economies, and other settings.
Okay. How do I get back to?
Yep, compass.
By northwest.
Go ahead and arrow over to the left. Make that the big screen again. There you go, and keep scrolling up.
Oh, there. Oh,
keep going. That's your digital.
Oh, that.
You already got
I don't
one.
Need that.
Yep.
Yeah, I want that.
There's your tire pressure.
Well, that's the tire pressure?
Yep. See the car with the tires?
Yeah.
And lets you know the PSI. Pretty
cool.
Fancy, huh? I like that.
Cool.
That's cool.
What am I?
Battery voltage.
Cruise set off.
There you go.
There. Okay.
And do you like the oil life on the right side? Do you like how much oil you have left, or do you like a different setting?
I don't really care how much oil I have left.
Well, yes, you do.
Yeah, you should.
Do we want to know that, Bob?
Yep, push it arrow to the right.
I haven't even opened the hood yet.
Push this one?
You also have the sticker in the upper left corner of the window up there,
yeah.
And that tells you how many miles you want to get your oil changed at.
Oh, yeah. Okay, pushing?
Yep, and that'll get on your oil life. See how it says 93%? Now, they recommend you, once you get down to about 20%, to get your oil change. Otherwise, follow that sticker.
Oh.
Okay. Do you want that left on, Bob?
How do you know all this?
I study my butt off. All I do is study.
So do we want oil life? What is a good one do you think?
Yeah, I would keep oil life on.
Okay.
I think that's one of your most important ones.
Okay.
Between that and tire pressure, that's always nice.
We always got that up there, huh?
Yep.
Okay.
But it doesn't necessarily, oil life doesn't necessarily go by miles. It goes by engine revolutions.
Oh.
So every time you turn the key off and it's got more revolutions, or turn the key on, that's actually how your oil life goes by.
Okay. When it comes on, I need one more time to be told this. When it comes on the service thing, but I want to get it back to this.
You just push it. The button in, but we're not going to have any more service things.
Well,
we're going to get you fixed.
All that information you've been giving us, is that all in here?
Yes, sir.
It is.
Yep. And actually, this one's going to be a little bit better for you, the personalization guide. The personalization guide shows you the whole screen, and it's got the little arrows pointing to every little technology, gizmo, gadget, dealio.
That way it doesn't show all of the things that you were doing.
Oh, yeah. It'll get in depth once you keep going farther in. It's going to break it down by section, kind of like how I was just doing it. And it'll show you cruise control on and off with that symbol. Okay?
This select button here is on this one, right?
Yep, exactly. There's your cruise on the left side, and there's the select on the right. Now, remember, they did this on a fully loaded vehicle, so some of these features you may not have.
Oh. Well, that's the personalization part.
Yep.
That.
Yeah, I would use that other book instead of that, the one that you were reading right there. That's more reading and more detailed. If you go to the personalization, it gives you the pictures and the symbols, which is a lot better.
The fatter book?
I wanted it.
The skinny one, this one with the pictures.
Oh,
this one's
going
to be the more handy one because it shows you the pictures and the arrows right to it and shows you the different. See how it's got the symbols on there?
Yep. It
shows you all the different positionings too. See how it's got the press left or right side of the control bar to select one of these three display zones, which we just went over. See that?
Holy crap, there's so much to know.
There's all kinds of stuff on this. But you know what? You just...
One thing I want to talk about, the RKTE transmitter, it talks about...